Good evening from New Delhi, India. Currently sat in the executive lounge of New Delhi train station. Today we're going to be doing a 5-star first class experience from New Delhi here at the train station all the way to Varanasi. It's going to take 12 hours overnight. We're in first class AC with our own bed and pillows and everything. But this is what we've got for around 300 rupees to start with. It's the executive lounge. 300 rupees for two, so that is 150 rupees. You've got the executive lounge here. There's a restaurant beyond there and a nice bathroom facility with showers. They have cricket on. So we've just been watching a little bit of cricket, relaxing in this AC before we go down onto the hectic platforms of New Delhi train station, and we'll find our first class seats. We're on platform D15. So I think that's like area D, and then platform 15, this train station is unbelievably big. Yeah, let's go down and see what first class 5-star express train to Varanasi, the holiest city in all of Hinduism, in all of India, the oldest city in India. It's going to be an exciting time. So we're on the second floor of New Delhi Airport. Not the airport, the train port. the train station. The second floor, so you have to come upstairs from the main entrance, and yeah, this is a little bit of a Halloween corridor you have to go down. It's basically the back rooms of Delhi, but down the bottom of these stairs is quite the experience. There are people sleeping all over the floor, there is hectic craziness, there is dogs inside the train station. No cows inside the station.
Which is a surprise! Yet.
But everything is going on, as you're about to see as we head down these stairs here. So, we've got our phones, everything, our pockets are zipped up. Most important step of travelling in India. And yeah, look at this, guys. As you can see, just a crazy scene at 10:30 at night here in New Delhi Airport. Is this where we need to be? I don't know. How do we tell where we need to be? Well, we've got to go through like a security right now, which we haven't had to do at any of the other stations. Just put our bags here like that, so, and then I'll go through. And then collect the bags at the other end. That's Paige's. And this is mine. Just small 20 litre backpacks. That's all you need when you travel in India. You want to be nimble and you want to be on the go. So let's figure out how to find the platform. There are stairs down the bottom. So if we need to get over onto the other platforms, then that will be possible. Here's a tuk-tuk in the train station and a dog. Any sort of indication on like where the platforms are. This is platform one.
Namaste.
Namaste. Namaste ji. Aapka naam kya hai?
Mohanlal Gupta.
Mohanlal Gupta. Mera naam Jack. Nice to meet you.
Pehchana?
Aap kaise ho? Acha. That was the guy who was sat in front of us on our first train in India, and he recognized us. That's so sweet. And in the whole journey that we were on that train, he didn't say a word to us, because I don't think he speaks any English, but that's so sweet that he was running after us. That's so nice. Okay, ladies waiting room only. The doggies. Okay, so platform 2 to 16. Now it said like
on our platform and said D15. So maybe that means like it's platform 15, but I don't know what the D means. I'm sure we'll find that out. We don't have too much time, to be honest. We've only got about 14 minutes until it actually starts moving, so
we'll
have to be a bit quick here. Right. Yeah, we went in the lounge for a whole of 10 minutes.
2 to 16 this way, I think. 2 to 16 that way. Okay, and here we are at the main overhead of the junction. Namaste. As you can see, just how sprawling this train station is.
Well, we'll find our station and we'll check it from there. So luckily, above all of the stations here, it has the train numbers. And I could see ours just before. I'm not seeing it now. Oh, there it is there. The New Delhi Banaras. There it is. 12582. And it's 15. And platform 14 and 15 is on the left here. So that's left. It says up here left. Wow. And we even get a non-working escalator. That's nice. These are always really strange to walk on because so used to them moving. But yeah, I can see our train is already here waiting for us, which is nice. Hopefully there's an opportunity to buy some water on the platform first. I think I can see a shop here. This is the very back of the train by the looks of it. Loading on all the loading on all the cargo. Someone's loading on a motorbike. All wrapped up, very nice colour. No, this is just a toilet, so we'll have to make do with the water we've got for now. And then hopefully we'll bring some water on the actual train itself. Right, so
figure out where to get on.
Yeah, let's see our ticket here. Just having a look now. So we are H1C. Well, this is first AC, and we are C8. H1, yeah, so H1 is written on the side there. And, there's a shop down there. How much time? We've got 10 minutes still, so we'll just secure our water because not a nice time. That looks like an advert for the water over here. Could be in luck, maybe not, maybe. I don't want the covered water. Let's see this over here. No, that's like a... Oh, there we go. Just waiting here, he's serving other people. Namaste, bhai saab. Ek pani? Also, there we go. Pani bhai bhai saab. We got some cold water and some, what was that, crisps?
Yeah.
Salted crisps, what are they?
Salted crisps.
Salted crisps. They're actually really nice, to be honest, these ones. Right, that's it. I've cut my arm on the railing of that shop a little bit. Wow.
Have you had your tetanus jab?
I've had my tetanus jab years ago. It's supposed to last a while. But here we are. Our first experience, first class in an Indian train. Next
what can you expect? Here is H1.
Welcome on board.
Namaste from RDG. Okay, so it's like private cabins, so we need to remember our cabin. Oh, so the door here. Very stiff door. So our cabin is C8.
So this is G.
Oh, okay. So it's just C for the cabin. And then our number of the bed at mine is 8 anyway. This is C. I wonder if there's anybody in. Yes, already okay. Somebody's in.
Nearly home, nearly coming home.
Namaste. 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 Yeah. I think we are up here. Yeah. We will be. We will be very quiet. We are very tired. Lots of trains today.
Yeah, we've been travelling as well for so long.
Yeah.
That's our last leg.
Where have you been?
We've been travelling for 2 months.
2 months?
Yeah, we came from England. Where you guys
we from? Also came from England, but only a week ago.
We've been traveling for two months.
Yeah.
And we came from Milton Keynes.
Really?
Where do you live in England?
Newcastle. Keynes has like...
either 5 hour drive from to Newcastle. Yeah.
There's like no roundabouts there, right?
No roundabouts. No roundabouts.
Oh, there's too many.
Too many.
That's it. Yeah.
I knew there. No traffic lights.
One or the other.
No I knew there was something about roundabouts in Milton Keynes. So, I'm just showing my friends back home what you get here.
Okay.
And you get a nice pillow, and this is for extra support, I think. And a blanket, and it's very, very cool in here, so that's everything that you could need, I think. Downstairs, you don't have to do that thing where you fell off the... Yeah, in sleeper class, it's so hard to get up on the top level. Okay, gonna get a good night's sleep. I'll check in with you soon. Well, here's me. This is the setup. There's a quilt under here. If I wanna use a blanket. But this is very relaxed, very cool. It's not quite the same atmosphere as the sleeper train, but it was always gonna be different. Slept well. It was a lot more boring than all the other trains that we've done, but the whole purpose was to sleep, and that I did. I slept for like 8 hours straight out of the 12 hours. Whoa, you look at this, we're pulling in, going through the villages and things first. This guy's selling coffee.
Coffee.
Be brought through to us. Mm-hmm.
coffee.
Okay. Okay.
Coffee, sir?
We've got a coffee.
As you can see, it looks quite nice actually.
It was 20 rupees for the coffee. So the chai tea is 10 rupees normally, and the coffee is 20, which is just 20 pence to wake up and have a coffee brought to your compartment here. It is a very, very nice treat. Let's see what else we can find. So, like I said, the journey was very different to all the other ones. Much less exciting. Well, that's not a problem, you know? What do we have here? As you can see, they're also getting their coffees delivered.
Lily milk.
Just going to dip in here. Oh, these are getting chai here, not coffee, which is also nice. So I'm going to continue. Let's get a little bit of fresh air while I enjoy this lovely coffee. It's very heavy dose. The doors are heavy to keep seeing. Yeah, it's a shame actually. On this train, the doors are not open. Came to see the doors will be open, but maybe that's only a sliver of the lower class. So there you go. That's something to consider if you wanted to sort of lean out of the door and let the wind hit your face like I've done in all the other trips of trains. Then you can't do that in the AC class. I guess it's because it will let the heat out. But namaste ji. Aapke se ho? Acha. But we'll be careful not to spill the coffee. Let's try it. That's a nice milky coffee. First thing on the morning. Don't expect to have great Italian espresso or French coffee or something like that in India. I've never been able to have it in a week, but you get used to it. Your body can go on without it. But yeah, so here's my final review. Well, how do I get in here? My final review, well, it was very secure. Each room like that has its own lock on the inside, so you can lock the room from the inside, which is good. You don't need to worry about your bag or anything like that. Nobody can get in, not even the ticket inspector could get in. He had to knock on the door to check the tickets. It was very quiet, very peaceful, very quiet, and the blankets and the pillows were all good, were all comfortable. Magnum. The AC was so cold that in the night I woke up and I was absolutely shivering. It was so, so cold. I had to put this jumper on, and even with this jumper, which has got thermal inside, it was still too cold. So if you're planning to get the AC trains here in India, you can't hang off the side of the train, you can't stand in the doorway, it's all closed. And after like 3-4 hours of the AC, you're so cold that you're going to need like one or two jumpers. So you have to add to your bag, your backpack, you have to add another like couple of jumpers. Or maybe if you get like a thermal layer, like a thin or like a thermal layer, that might be helpful. Then you get coffee, which is nice. And then, other than that, it's a good night's sleep. You can't really see much because it's through the night. But yeah, I think most people are just wanting to sleep on these trains anyway. They're not wanting like some sort of adventure, but I do like that. Namaste, G. Yeah, that's everything. That's everything that I would say about these trains. Very, very nice compartment areas that lock for safety. They're extremely cold and very boring if you look at something interesting. But I promise I would show you how it was, and that's how it is. Will I do it again? No, I'll probably never get on this type of train again. Because the sleeper train would have cost about £3 to do this journey, and it's so much fun, and you meet so many people, and you get the same types of chai, and you get more food options, because when the food guy was coming up and down here, we were on the top bunk. By the time I'd like gotten down off the bunk, unlocked the door and opened the door, he was already gone. So like, we didn't get any food. Whereas in sleeper, we just like woke up and went, ah, biryani, great, and got it. So yeah, and this cost £26. This journey cost £26, which is a lot for India. India's £26 first class train, sleeper train. Would I recommend it? Would I rate it? No. Would I recommend it? If you want a good sleep and you've been traveling a while and you're a bit tired now, yeah, definitely worth getting a good 10 hour sleep on it. Okay, until the next video in Varanasi, I'll see you later. I'm gonna enjoy this coffee. Goodbye.